webs. Dude, the chat's actually so distracting. Yeah, I'm gonna like watch it.
Right here.
Okay, we got MB Smash TM against Ginger Beach.
Okay, they're going right into it.
This is loser semis, it says?
Yeah. Looks like so this is a BO5, I guess.
Yeah. I'm happy we get a BO5.
That's kind of weird that winner semis wasn't BO5, but loser semis is.
Wait, winner semis wasn't?
Yeah.
That's weird, yeah. Three. Yeah.
But I'm not the TO. I'm just the commentator, so. Okay, green team down to stock right now, but the percents are like looking in their favor. If they can take these two pretty quick, then they'll be in a good position.
So, I know we saw Ginger and Beach upset the Coffee Black Nightmare team earlier.
Would you really call that an upset?
That's true, though, yeah.
That's like a very small upset, if any.
That's very true, yeah. And the way they did it was like Ginger literally just 2v1. Like, he played out of his mind.
Yeah, and he just kind of. And Beach, as you know, Beach knows what his role is. He knows that he needs to stick in the support position. And,
yeah.
You know, help Ginger when he gets hit or when the team completes.
Oh, for sure. Like, I'm saying Ginger 2v1, but like, he went in 2v1 because Beach was able to like support him so
yeah,
well.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, you know that if they hit you, Beach could come with a dash attack, break that up. You know, if you get a hit, Beach covers it. Yeah, that was
Roy's
a big mistake.
Yeah, but you know, like, I think that's a very good strategy in general teams. You know, like, one player is, you know, a lot more, like, fast and, like, deadly and technical than the other player. But, like, Stiff and I kind of do that a lot, too, where, like, I'm just kind of going in and he's my support too, so.
I'll say, is Stiff a technical player in your team or what?
Oh, yeah, totally.
I teamed with Ginger back at a Change of Heart over the summer.
Oh, really?
And what he told me, he's like, literally just sit on like the platform on the side of the stage and wait till I get a hit and then you kill them.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay. He's like, if you're ever scared, just go to the platform and hide. I will protect you. And I'm like, okay. And we won. Ginger's amazing.
Okay. Really good team combos right now.
Yeah. Like, it's one of those things. I have this idea where it's like, you have the general role of like, I'm the aggressor, I'm the more passive player. But you also like, in each situation, there's like a role you have to know to do, right?
Yeah.
And these guys have been playing together so long, they know every situation. Like, I do this and you do this. There's no, you don't have to say it, right?
These are definitely, you know, two of the longest running static teams in Michigan, you know, Melee. So the teamwork, you know, is pretty fantastic in this set. You know?
I kind of wanted to see Ginger go for MB there instead of get the edgeguard against TM. Like, he could have gotten a team combo. I think it's better than trying to edgeguard Ganon. He's really hard to edgeguard in teams.
Yeah, when Ginger and Beach were playing against Ice and Duck, at the beginning, they're kind of getting messed up because they were, like, going after Duck. They're chasing him down, like, when he's recovering and stuff. But then game two, you know, they brought it way, way closer. And I think they did that by starting to focus on Ice. You know, it's like, it doesn't matter if, you know, Duck has four stocks, if Ice doesn't have four. And I think you can kind of view this matchup in a similar light. Like, if you can just kill Ganon a bunch, you know, it doesn't really matter. Like, you can let MB, you know, do whatever he wants if he's trying to play massively.
Yeah, in teams, it's like no stock rather than the other person's stock, because you can always just share stocks.
Yeah.
So it's like, all you have to do is get those stocks down.
Okay, that was a pretty good sandwich by Green Team right there. Red Team needed to, you know, do a lot on these last two stocks, but they ended up taking a lot of damage before they got one of the Green Teams.
SD from Ginger. I think he was like 120%. It's not the hugest deal, but
yeah.
Can't SD in teams, man. I actually think SDing in teams is like the worst. You feel so shitty because it's like,
yeah,
I'm letting my teammate down.
I SD'd like 5 times. Let's not talk about it. Okay. MB off stage. Good job holding space right there by TM, just to make sure MB can come back. This is a lot of pressure we have to put on by Green Team right now.
Yeah. So earlier we saw Team MB go against like ID Crisis Nexic, and one thing that Green Team does differently that ID Crisis Nexic didn't do is like, when you're in the, each team has their own side of the stage, Green Team just shoots projectiles. It makes it so hard for you to do anything.
Yeah, for sure.
Like, Green Team is so comfortable in every scenario.
Yeah, especially, you know, they're really good at, like, layering themselves. Okay, but this is super close.
Yeah, that's a sick edgeguard from MB, and they actually could win this game now.
Yeah, Beach really needs to live right now. Oh, that poof was crucial, actually. Okay, nice shield drop up there, though. Ginger's got this.
Oh, yeah. That's one stock, and now he's a solid percent lead.
Yeah, this is gonna be tough. This matchup's rough, too. Ooh, okay. Putting a lot of corner pressure on right now. Just being safe. He knows that Ganon wants those dirty ledge options.
Yeah, he knows if he just like plays safe in lasers, he probably has this. Yeah. So no reason to do the risky play.
Yeah, because Ganon can kill you off one touch or one grab or something like that.
I mean, I've definitely seen TM do the chain grab before.
Yeah, it's super tough too. Oh, okay, that was really crucial. Nice jab there. Okay.
I think that's it. Yeah.
Okay, man, really close first game right there.
Yeah. This is actually like one of the most even sets we've had in doubles so far.
Yeah, right. There's definitely been a lot of live sets.
It's cool. It's like it's two long-standing teams.
Mm-hmm.
It's two very evenly matched
teams.
Yeah,
and they've always been around the same, you know, skill level.
Both with one PR player, one former PR player.
Yeah.
I like it. both with some of the sickest Sheiks in Michigan. Beach, MB.
Beach,
MB. MB, let's go. I consider MB Michigan.
Oh, no. Toledo.
Toledo is Michigan, just, yeah.
We annex them. It's reverse, the reverse situation of real life. Because, like, UP. They're on a UP Smash.
Oh, yeah.
Deep Sea Squid is the only UP Smash.
I actually played with it with Icy's from UP.
And Tess. Shout out to Tess.
There's one, like, Icy's from Michigan Tech who was, like, here for the summer.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Huh. I forget his tag.
Yeah. But, you know, Toledo just comes out all the time. Because it's only, like, 45 minutes, right?
Yeah. I mean, everyone came to this tournament, dude. We have Ohio. We have Columbus.
I was kind of a little surprised. Like, we don't have, like, Swedish coming out. Maybe a couple more people from Canada.
Yeah.
But who knows? Maybe he's, like, migrating over to the West Coast a little early. I know, like, a bunch of people are, like, just going over to the West Coast to, like, boot camp for, like, a week before Genesis.
Yeah. You know? So there's one, like, decent-sized Ohio tournament this weekend as well, which is where, like, guys like Hanky Panky and Drefin are.
Oh, okay.
But we still have some Ohio players. We have a lot of Chicago. We have seven Chicago. We have six Canada? Five Canada?
Really?
A lot of Canada.
Nice, yeah. Canada is always good about coming out to our events, you know. Canada and Michigan are definitely homies.
Yeah, thank you for watching, guys. And, of course, Beach does the 6 minute between game talk.
All right, dude, we're going to break down analyze the entire last game.
It's good. Like,
no, it is good to slow it down and talk with your partner, especially when you barely won. The first game, you know, kind of cool the other people down, because you know they're going to be coming in, trying to come out, like, swinging for this game, too. Yeah, just kind of trading some blows.
Yeah, it's just been, like, backer trades.
Okay, this is a big opportunity. Nice job. No one can get that soft air by Ginger.
Yeah. And good then Beach is there to prevent the edge guard as well.
Yep. Good down smash. He almost killed TM with that down smash, actually. Both green team off stage right now. Oh, the poof. I don't think he meant for the poof to save TM right
there.
Oh, wow. That was a really convenient. Wow. Weak Sheik up air into Falco up air as he was coming off the spawning platform.
Just a free gift, man. Dude, Ginger's going in so hard right now.
Yeah, he's going ham. Dude, he knows how to put the hands on Ganondorf. He has so much Ganondorf experience. Yeah. Honestly.
The second he sees the Sheik 1v1, he's like, all right, I'm going in.
Yep. Especially because, you know, the Sheik 1v1 can devolve into really, like, long strings of, like, combos.
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes. So, like, you know you got a decent amount of alone time in this game. I don't really think that was worth it or not worth it either way, you know?
I think he just misspaced it. Like, it wasn't worth it, but if he had gotten it, it would have been, like, obviously worth it.
This is pretty even, though. Ginger's got to try to stay alive right now.
Oh, yeah. Mistake
from
TM. Oh,
he's going to get the up air, too. Oh, wow. I thought that was going to kill. But, oh, nice.
Getting a bit too heavy, but that will kill, actually.
Yeah, that's the thing about Falco in this, you know, this matchup that we have going right now. Can definitely just get knocked around and die in, like, 60 or 70 really easily.
Oh, yeah. That's, like, the strength of this team, right? They're both characters who want to just, like, wait and then get, like, an 80% combo and kill you.
But, you know, I don't think that's been really happening to Ginger that much in this set, just because, like, you know, he's kind of the dominant player on the field right now.
Yeah.
He is the one who's going to be winning a majority of the 1v1 situations. He's kind of dictating the pace.
Plus, like, it's hard for, like, Ganon can get a few hits and get kills off just a couple hits, but Sheik's combos are, like, long, right?
Yeah.
So your teammate can always come and help you if it's, like, a Sheik comboing you.
Yep.
Bit of a miscue there off stage. I think they could have, like, seen each other.
Okay,
it's even.
Yeah.
I feel like it hasn't been even this game, but Red Team's just holding it together, man.
They've been trading back and forth quite a bit.
Yeah, they're really good at getting a lot out of a little.
Okay. So, yeah, Red Team definitely came out on bottom on that exchange right there in the middle. So let's see how Green Team capitalizes on this. Nice needles to free up the ledge by MB right there. I felt like that was kind of a big opportunity. Red Team had them both knocked down in the middle of the stage, and they didn't really capitalize that hard. So that might come back and bite them. Nice.
Yeah, they still control. It might fall to Ginger again, actually.
Yeah, I can see them just going to Ginger right now. But they're both off stage right now.
Oh, come on. They missed both edgeguards. Oh.
Yeah, I like the principle of, you know, Ginger going out to help Beach with the edgeguard because Ganon takes so long to recover. But I think, you know, Beach probably could have done it by himself, and then Ginger could have got the edgeguard.
Yeah, like, it was a guaranteed edgeguard, I think, for TM. So I would have taken the edgeguard against Ganon.
That was that super one, good by Ginger. Oh,
oh,
no. He tries to go a little too hard right there. I mean, that was probably a free down smash by the ledge for MB right there. But I think rolling the dice and trying to get back to the ledge right there was probably the better idea instead of trying to, like, go for the super duper, like, you know, optimal option.
Yeah.
And shorten. Tough decision, though. Like, to make that in the split second right there. Shorten or no shorten.
This is definitely the ginger counter pick, not the green team counter. It's the ginger counter pick.
Definitely.
He can go so ham on this stage against Sheik and Ganon, especially. It's like, what do they do on this stage?
Okay. Green team had, you know, good stage positioning right there. Doing a lot of damage to red team, just keeping them in the corner. Yeah, I think this is definitely a good counter pick because they can just put so much pressure when red team is in the corner. Just lock them down, keep them there.
Beach needs to be better at hitting those edge guards. Like, Ginger's job is to hold ledge there, and Beach, all you have to do is fair. Like, it's so easy. He has nowhere to go. There's so much lag.
Let's see if they can pick this up on TM. Oh, man. Goes in a little too close to that back air. Green team taking a lot of damage right now. If they can, you know, make this combo sequence into two kills right now, that would be huge.
They get one.
Oh, okay. Good get up attack on the ledge by Ginger right there.
He's hitting like six
lasers
on Beach. That should be a stock unless Beach can do some sick saves. Yeah, not happening.
Yeah. Once MB got the ledge, it's gonna be pretty tough for Ginger to, or for Beach to get over there.
You have to needle, and it's just hard with two players there.
Yeah, I think Ginger definitely should have just let Beach get like the forward air right there after that up tilt, because he kind of had the job of, you know, edgeguarding TM, and he kind of dropped it and continued his combo on stage.
Yeah.
Ended up working out, though. MB dies.
It really says the philosophy here is, like, don't worry too much about TM if you can get the 2v1.
Yeah, especially when he's recovering.
And it's it's kind of not working. They're not getting the 2v1 they need to justify that decision.
Yeah, definitely. It looks like they're hesitating quite a bit on who they want to target when they have an opportunity for a 2v1. If they want to go for it, they don't want to. Man, that down air almost killed.
Ooh. Oh, man. Beach getting so much damage.
Yeah. It looks like TM is taking a bunch of damage once he's at zero, but last knock he went to 220.
He was there for like 2 minutes, yeah.
That's like the duck effect, you know?
Yeah, it's like you spend so much time recovering, they just can't like rack up for same on you. He can't combo you.
Okay, Ginger almost got paired off stage right there. He does get paired off stage right there. Okay, opportunity for a team combo right there, yeah. Lasers are so good for preventing your teammate from edgeguarding. It's a good tool for Falco.
Double edgeguard here.
Cool, okay, that's gonna kill.
Yeah, they seem awkward in 2v1 there.
Yeah, for sure. Ginger looks content to just get this 1v1 on Ganon at 0% right now. Like, because TM, or because MB is at such high percent, like, if he's gonna play, like, over by the ledge and try to stay alive, I think Ginger's fine with that. Final's just taking the 2v1 against Ganondorf, so.
Green team really can't afford these, like, crazy Ganon stocks, though. Like, they're only gonna live so long, and then they're just racking up, like, percent slowly, getting the 1-2 hits they need, and getting the kills eventually.
Ginger's laser's not really working out right there, honestly. Ooh, okay, but that was huge. The fact that MVP got hit by that bear, that actually cost him a stock.
Oh, okay. They went the wrong way, unfortunately, but still a good sequence. And this game's like super even now.
This is super doable, actually.
Yeah, for either team, because like they're both high percent green team.
Okay, that was a super good attack by TM, but it doesn't look like he's gonna make it back.
Yeah, good edge guard.
Yeah, nice. Okay, this is gonna be super tough now. Oh, that was almost super sick.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, well, you can tell those team combos are just so practiced, honestly. You can tell that they knew exactly what they were doing.
Yeah.
That was super good.
A couple of missteps, but they still got like a lot of percent off them.
Yep. Oh, right.
I think he was trying to do the jab infinite and just like was too close and jab.
I mean, he's at 120. Like, I don't really know why.
You got a style, man.
Alright, down set's gonna do it. Ginger Beach. Up,
Winner's Finals has not been played yet. Japanese character 420.
Memes, dude. Oh my god.
Legion. Yeah, the Ganon was living way too long that entire set.
Yeah, that was tough. It's 2-1 though for green team. I wonder what kind of counter pick we're gonna see. Did they already play in Battlefield? Because I'd imagine that would be the preferred counter pick.
So the first counter pick was it Pokemon?
I don't know.
I can't remember the stage selection.
Remember,
I feel like you go like either Battlefield or Yoshi's.
Well, yeah, that's what I was thinking too. But I think they already went to Battlefield. I think that's the game they went on.
Fuck off. No, Mingy. No. This is experienced commentators only.
Can I commentate with Sheep?
No. It's not the streamer's decision.
Yeah. Right. Dude, the classic talk to the commentator while he's commentating.
Yeah. Come on, dude.
It's like, thanks, man. The worst when they ask you questions to go, like, where's my pool? And I'm like, are you real?
How about you ask the TO? Not me. I got a job. All right, yeah, so Yoshi's, yeah, that's what you were thinking.
It's one of those things where, like, the strength they have is Ganon living a while and getting those, like, crazy fares, and Yoshi's just so good for that. For sure, you just get two hits and they're dead.
Yeah, if Ganon can get, like, two or three fares that kill a character at, like, 60 or 70, then, you know, that's how you know the comic is. But when you get a fare on your teammate, that's the danger of this map as well, is them hitting each other. So.
They both have large hitboxes and large hurtboxes, so it's really easy to hit your teammate.
Oh, that was sick.
That was sick, yeah.
Alright, Ginger gets the edge guard right there, but Beach is definitely doing a good job. I'm sorry, commentator. Damn, really just jockeying for stage positioning right now. It looks like red team pushing them back a little bit, but that shine will open the stage up for green team.
Yeah, I like how green team has like the go switch, right? Like, you're doing the lasers, you're doing the camping, you're doing whatever. Second you get the hit, it just go.
Yeah, they both go in super hard. Ooh, man, pretty big mistake for Beach right there. You can tell he leans forward in his chair. He's not happy about that.
Oh, what?
Oh no, now he edge guards him. Oh no, that was so
good. That was such a good edge guard from him.
They ended up getting TM, but TM was at super high percent. I don't think TM really cares that he lost his sock right there.
Good F smash there. Definitely worth it. Needles less so.
Yeah, green team, you know, falling apart a little bit right now. Looks like the chaos of Yoshi's is kind of getting to him a little bit.
A bit. They're just making those small mistakes, right?
Yep.
It feels like they're ahead 90% of the game. When you make those two mistakes, it gets a team like Sheik Ganon, they just take it to the bank every
Especially,
time.
You know, like, if you down smash your opponent and then, like, Ganon hits your teammate, or you can down smash your teammate and then Ganon hits him, like, that is so much percent off, like, one little thing that you messed up on.
TM and MB are too good to, like, make those silly mistakes.
Yeah, for sure. And I think, you know, I said this in a different TM MB set that I commentated earlier, like, one of the dangers of Yoshi's in general is that you can hit your teammate a lot, especially with characters, like, who have huge hitboxes, like Sheik and Ganon, but they're so comfortable with each other that I don't think, like, Yoshi's bothers them, you know what I mean? Like, they're gonna be fine spacing around each other no matter how small the stage is.
Yeah.
And so you can really reap the benefits that Ganon, you know, gets on the stage.
It's just that, it's that long-term partner advantage, man.
Yep.
Okay. With a team like Sheik, you kind of have to have it.
Good combos on both sides, though. Yeah. Both Sheiks kind of got messed up right there. But now it's Ginger all alone. And he... Yeah, I was going to say, he can do this, but he can't even get opened up once, or else it's going to be super tough. Is he going to get it? Ooh.
I think MB can get it.
Okay.
Oh, Randall.
Randall giving him a second chance. Okay. Really clutch manual right there.
Double laser is definitely not the right choice.
Oh, there it is. Oh, no, he's still alive. Godlike DI. Yeah. Okay, that's going to do it, though. All right, game five. Let's go.
Did you have some questionable decisions off the ledge there?
Yeah.
Questionable choices, sure. But.
Yeah. And he ends up, you know, just like prolonging his death rather than like getting himself an opportunity to win that 2v1.
Yeah, I mean, it's tough though, right?
Dude, 2v1s are so hard.
2v1s when people know what their role is, know what they're supposed to be doing, is like, how do I deal with this? Yeah. The second you hit one, then everyone just kills you.
Yeah, it's like, how do you be safe? Like getting damage in a 2v1. Like, yeah, maybe like one of them mess up and give you an opening, but if you run in and like grab them and think you're gonna kill them, but like Ganon just punches both of you, you know what I mean? It works out for the team.
It feels like usually when you win a 2v1, it's like you get the quick 1-2 kill on somebody and then you get back to the 1v1.
Yep.
It's rare you get like the actual extended 2v1 of take the
Ginger's
full stock.
Biggest opportunity in that 2v1 is right at the beginning, right as you know, Peach died before they were ready for the setups and stuff. Okay. Beach looking like he's content to just kind of throw needles, help Ginger out, be the aggressor. That was good by Ginger, though. He immediately recognized that Beach got grabbed by the ledge, whatever that is.
Yeah, it's one of those scenarios where, like, that's like what, like, Fox presents Falcon, because it takes kind of a while for Falcon to get there.
Yeah.
So you can still, like, laser and just bring it up.
Yeah, that's simply, you know, a good tool of Falco's in doubles. Especially, like, you can help your partner get back to the stage while you're all the way across on the other side, just with, you know, lasers messing up their opponent that opponent's
time. I think it's really cool how like the laser is such a vital tool in both doubles and singles, but in very different ways for very different reasons.
Yeah, definitely. Okay. It looks like Green Team is content to play a little bit more passively on this stage right now. I think that the space that Pokemon has given them is like, you know, freeing up their options to play a little bit slower.
Those needles from Mewtwo are actually so good. They hit MB on the ledge, which gave Ginger the Hedgehog.
Yeah. Similar thing as Falco's laser is like what I just talked about. Oh man, that really high up down air gets the right angle and kills TM. Oh man, they're messing up MB Smash right now, dude.
Ooh. Beach has the roll though from ledge, 2%.
Yeah. Can't get any edge guard.
Yeah, that would have been huge. If Beach would have been able to get up in time and like, you know, get that edge guard to MB, that would have been huge. But comfortable read right now for Green Team. And, oh, and that was a big mistake. Messing up that up smash, you know. They wasted a lot of time right there. As to where, you know, if TM just would have gone for the combo and Ginger, they probably would have. Yeah, they're just having a really hard time finishing these stocks off right now, and it's costing them a lot.
Yeah, I mean, it's more than 2 minutes in, and he's only lost one stock.
Yeah. And now, yeah, Red Team are both at death percent right now. Like, double dare? Nope.
Yeah, like, honestly, credit to Beach for staying as long as he has.
Yeah, for sure. And Ginger, too, you know, Falco at 140 on doubles.
It's oh, impressive.
Yeah, sick, man. He's living to 140.
He gets edgeguard, too? He gets the edgeguard, too!
Wow. Green Team went ham this game.
Yeah. Game 5, definitely looking, I think, like, the least close of the games we've seen so far.
Yeah. Yeah, just look how locked down TM was right there. Like, Ginger was getting a combo, but TM just couldn't find his way out of the corner. Like, Sheik was just sitting there.
It's hard for Ganon. How do you get past Sheik as Ganon?
And that dare. Okay.
Yeah.
Transformation might be an opportunity for them to make a big comeback right now, but...
It might be, but they're down 3 stocks.
And Ganon is just so limited on this stage. What else is TM going to do but
just
sit
look
right
at this.
There?
Yeah. Dude, Green Team, like, knows this scenario and practices this, right? It's like, I'm going to laser, you sit there so they can't approach, and you just have to run away.
Yep.
Look at that.
And, like, look, now they're, like, behind the cliff, and, like, think about how bad their stage positioning is going to be when the transformation goes down. Like, they're just going to take that space
yeah.
out easily.
Green Team was so quick about taking this position.
Yeah.
Like, so Red Team is one chance. They have to get 2 kills really quickly.
Yeah, and look how Beach just lets Ginger go forward and take his place. Nice lasers to interrupt that grab right there.
Well, that's one, that's two.
Okay.
This is all of a sudden a
this
bit
is doable.
Doable.
Yeah, no, if they need to kill Ginger. Like,
yeah, it relies on a Ginger though. Game. It's so hard to game Sheik.
But now they're both getting comboed. Oh, this is really rough. Oh, and MB throws some needles off the stage and dies for it. It's looking like that's going to be it.
Bit of a one-sided end to a very close set.
Yeah, for sure.
Unless we see the sickest comeback of all time.
Dude, again in at 150 top.
That would be the sickest comeback of all time.
Three fresh stocks
no
up.
Doubt.
But I think the forward tilt is going to finish. Yep. All right, good stuff. Ginger and Beach moving on to Losers Finals.
That's really good. Are they? I guess Winners Finals haven't played yet, right? So now we have, they play loser
so.
Of...
This next match that's
it's
about to come
Ice
on.
Duck, KJ Chibu.
KJ Chibu, yep. Predictions for that? How do you think it's going to
go? So clearly, Ice...